Let's tell everyone. I just want to show you real quick what I want to do here is, there is only two. If you want to do deletion of your rows in your table, there is only two ways of doing that. Delete and truncate. Then with the delete, you can be able to let the SQL Server know that okay, there is a one once you want to delete and the one you want to left out. You can be able to delete the one you want and leave the one you don't want to delete, but with the truncate we remove all the datas in the table, remove all the rows, so if you want to use a delete, you must specify the rows that you want to be deleted, and let the SQL Server know. If you did not specify and let the SQL Server know the one you want to delete and go ahead and just delete without giving condition, it's going to remove all the data in your table. And just be careful with doing that whenever you are using delete statement. But with truncate, there is nothing, no statement, no condition to be given. With the statement, you just delete all the data, all the rows. So without wasting your time, I've already done this, but I just want to kind of highlight the way or the statement that you can be able to use to do the truncate your table and remove all the rows in your table. So for example, this is my own database. So you put on your database here and enter the truncate the statement here. So this truncate table, then you provide the schema. Normally this is by default, this is schema for SQL Server, and the table you want to do truncate on and run the code. I've already done this, but I just want to show you the statement. So what you're gonna do is just put on your database, then put the statement and add the schema abbreviation name, then with your table name you want to do it, you want to remove the data and run this code. That's what it is. All right, thank you for watching. See you some other time. Bye for now.